Women are pretty hot here, but I don't really know how to approach them, you know, because they drink too, so it's really hard to see who's gonna f*** you, you know? The last time I was here, I did hook up with a beautiful Irish girl, and we made love, and afterwards she goes, that was kind of queek. Kind of queek. And I'm thinking, yeah, but with the time difference, that was like hours of sex. It's gotta be hard for you guys. You know, here I am, some American dude. You know, I came over here for the same reason a lot of other people did, you know, to start a terror cell and, of course, spread anthrax. Dublin, thank you very much. It's been an old pleasure. Woo, who ordered the McBomb? Who cares? This week, I'm in Dublin, Ireland. Sounds cool, huh? Wait, it gets better. It's also St. Patrick's Day, the one day a year when everyone's Irish. So call me Davy O'Tell, and let the celebration begin. We're off. Come on, it's St. Patrick's Day in Dublin. What's up, Harvard? What are you doing over here?
I'm a young Bill Clinton. I'm actually studying abroad.
Here. Are you?
Because I'm.
Which one is it? Yeah, with the spirit. Yeah! Oh, sorry. Someone drank the baby. Woohoo! This is just a line to throw up. Check me. Civic Museum, that sounds it. Wait, there's a pub over here. Come on.
Do you want to buy me a pint?
I do.
Okay, I'd like that. Do you actually like the stout?
I don't know. I'm more of a Budweiser dude, you know?
I've just spent 3 months in Asia, and I've been forced to drink beer, and that's not fun.
Well, welcome back to Guinness.
Thank you very much.
Sláinte.
Yeah.
And that's Gaelic for toast?
It's Irish for health.
For health. Sláinte.
Up your bum.
There's ice in it. Is that even allowed?
That's boomers.
Boomers.
Yeah, and the reason I'm drinking it is the ice helps me piss better.
It does?
Yeah, because otherwise, if you don't drink it without ice, you get this burning sensation in your penis.
Oh, you sure that's from the ice? Here I am, partying it up in Dublin. Dublin. Yes. Thank you, ladies.
You're welcome.
Let me just enjoy the moment.
You're very, very welcome. Give a little peck on the cheek.
Oh. Skyfest, St. Patrick's Day. I'm not the only thing lit in this town. Check that out. Oh. We're surrounded. Too bright. Oh. You guys want to make out or something? These fireworks are getting me a little riled up. It's supposed to calm me down. Yeah? Drink. What's the shot, man?
Sucking cowboy.
Yeah. Sucking, yeah.
No, that's the name of it. Sucking
cowboy. Okay, here we go. There's gonna be some hurling tonight. Not that kind of hurling, this kind of hurling. One of the official Gaelic games and the national sport of Ireland. Check it out. Crazy game. Hey, what's up?
Hey, how are things?
This is Pat. You're the coach. Now, you can tell me what's going on. This is a wild sport, man.
It's the fastest field game in the world.
It is.
Basically, it's a uniquely Irish sport. It's called hurling.
It's called hurling. And I'll tell you, I've never seen this before, and I have ESPN3. It's a cool game, man. It's like a combination of many games, like lacrosse, highlight, badminton, soccer. It looks like it's like a mulligan stew.
Well, no. Well, we like to think it's a pure game.
Pure game.
We like to call it God's own game, really.
What do you need to do to play hurling?
Main thing that you need,
is a hurley stick.
This is it?
This is it, or a hurl.
Look at that, it looks like a tomahawk.
It's a stick, you use it left and right. You can hit it with that side or with that side.
Uh-huh.
And that's the ball that we use. It's called a slitter.
It looks like American baseball.
Except smaller.
Hit the slitter with the hurley. Hit the slitter with the hurley.
And,
is that a Thin Lizzy song?
No.
Now, what's the objective? Control the field, control the ball, what is it?
The objective is to get the ball over the bar or under the bar more times than the opposition.
Now, oh! I think he scored. I'm not exactly sure. It is very complicated. Oh! No pads, huh?
No. Well, some guys would wear shin guards, but, you know.
Yeah, I'd like a pair. And a cup. Good thing I always wear a cup.
As you see, there's sticks flying and bodies flying, and unless you know how to protect yourself, you're going to get hurt.
Well, Pat, I love a challenge. Hold my hat. We're in on the action. There goes the slither. Block it! Finnegan, I got you! Are you open? Oh! Yeah! Oh! Stop! Damn. Where were you? My knee? I surrender. You were right. I could not do it, Pat. Can I get a shot? Yeah. All right, the hurling. Chemical Crouch! Damn! Yes! You're from Canada. Oh, okay. All right. Are you having a good St. Pat's?
Yes, I am.
This is your buddy here. Let me get a picture of you two. Yes. Oh, the luck of the Irish. No, I'm lucky. Taking a break from the bars. There's so many, we can't hit them all. I only have one liver. Hold the bus. You got it. You're welcome. Let's get a drink to celebrate. What pub is this?
Cobblestone. Yeah.
Let me get something. What's the house specialty?
Well, we got a Darcy's, we got a local stout, we got a local lager that's made across the road there, and we got a red beer as well.
Let me get the red beer. Look at that. Now watch it disappear. Mmm. Magically delicious. Oh. Yeah, what's up? No, I'm in Dublin. You don't believe me? Listen.
You like it here, yeah?
I really do. Is he going to grant me a wish? I don't know. I'd like you to meet some new late-night friends of mine. This is Owen and Frank.
Well done, yeah. You got the names right.
Okay, now, that looks like some kind of mandolin. What kind of instrument is that, Frank?
It's called a bouzouki.
A bouzouki?
An Irish bouzouki.
Now, I don't remember that in school when they said pick an instrument. Do you want to play the trombone or the bouzouki? How did you pick that up?
He made it himself.
You made it?
He did.
And what's that, Owen? What is that? That looks like a bong, basically.
A bong?
Yes.
You can't smoke this, yeah. This is called a New York bagpipe.
It's a New York bagpipe?
New York bagpipe.
Really?
Actually, Chicago.
A Chicago, that's a thicker crust? That's a thicker crust.
It's
kidding, that's pizza. You don't do any covers, like Far Side of the Moon or anything like that? You don't do any covers, Anagata, nothing?
No.
This is all traditional stuff.
Yeah, and you don't really decide what you're going to play until the moment you start playing it.
Standing room only here at the Cobblestone Pub. What's up, man? How you doing?
I'm fine. Not too bad.
My name's Dave.
My name's Benoit.
Benoit?
Yeah.
Have you heard of the Benoit balls? You must get that all the time. Do you know what they are?
No.
Benoit balls? Is your name really Benoit?
Yeah, it is.
I'm not going to go there. It's too easy. Anyway, it's something that really pleases the ladies. Benoit. Now, how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing fine.
Slancha.
Slancha.
Mainly HBO and Amish Irish. Which means that we would be.
All right, don't get old Gaelic on me. An Irishman, a Welshman, and an Englishman walk into our pub.
A Scotsman, a Welshman.
Sorry.
No.
Okay,
no,
a Scotsman, a Welshman, and an Englishman.
And is this a popular program in the States?
Well, it was. No, it, people are changing channels as we speak. St. Patrick's Day isn't all drinking and fun. Sometimes it looks like this.
Master, cut a leprechaun, and I won't let you down until you lead me to your crack of gold.
I promise.
Ho, 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 ho. Did you see that too? This place looks happening.
Welcome to Club Spirit!
not just about dancing. This is the chill out room. So chill out. Now, what is the name of the show, Lisa? What is it?
The name of tonight's show is Prophecy.
That must be exhausting. How long do you do this?
We start at 12:30 and we'll finish at about 5:00.
5 in the morning?
Yeah.
Man, so that's how you get those abs, right? Look at that guy. Man, look up at that guy. That's quite revealing there. It's quite a shamrock you got there. You live in somebody's dream, working in a club, dancing in a club all night.
Yeah, it is a dream, really, isn't it? To us, it's just...
It's fun.
It's so much fun.
It's fun watching it. I have to say, you guys do an amazing job. Prophecy. And I know mine. I'm going to be drunk, going home, and thinking about this in a very lewd way. We'll be right back! St. Patrick's is a lot better, I'll tell you. Yeah, if you can drink on it. If you drink on Christmas, you have a problem. If you drink on St. Patrick's, you're just having a good time. Look, I've got a whole bunch of Euros and a lifesaver. I'm ready for anything. Hey, what's up? I want you to meet one of my oldest friends, Jameson Whiskey. It's been a while, huh, buddy? It sure has. Let's meet again. What's up, ladies? How are you doing here?
We're doing great.
So am I. I'm drinking my Jameson. Do you drink whiskey?
I do. I like Jameson.
Are you single?
Yes, I am.
Oh, God, I found her. The show's over. Where do you live? Do you have a job?
I do have
a job. Oh, my God, 3 for 3. Hey, I wonder what's going on back in the States. Here's someone who can help me, Frank O'Brien, ham radio operator. Frank, how you doing?
Well, I'm trying to do it at the moment.
Okay. We're trying to contact the States to find out how the St. Pat's is going on over there. So this is a hobby?
This is a hobby, absolutely.
Okay. And have you talked to people all over the world?
At any one time of the day, we could be talking to Japan one moment, China the next. We'll be talking to the Pacific. You could be talking to the South Pole or the North Pole.
You've talked to the poles. You've talked to the South Pole, North Pole. So there's 335 countries in the world. How many, Frank, have you contacted?
334.
334?
Yeah.
Who's the holdout?
I have one to go. The holdout is Andaman and Nicobar Islands.
The Andaman Nicobar Islands.
Andaman Nicobar in the Bay of Bengal.
Why not the internet? I mean, really, that's kind of the wave of the future. Okay. Everybody keeps connected. Okay. Global village. Why not?
There's no satisfaction.
Yeah.
In pressing a button and just calling up whatever you want. There's no satisfaction there. The challenge is to guess what is out there, and you don't know what's out there. This is the I2GS, and this is St. Patrick's Day Special Event Station. We have mild weather here today, excellent weather for St. Patrick's Day parade and celebrations, and I have a friend with me in the shack who has no experience of ham radio. Roger?
Hello, Roger.
Okay, now, I want to give him an opportunity for to say hello to you. All right?
Hi, this is Dave. Are you celebrating St. Patrick's Day there? Really? Really? I'm wishing everybody back in the States a happy St. Patrick's Day. And here's a little something for you. Well, thank you. Do I say over and out? Over and out.
73.
Frank,
yes.
Thank you, man, for helping me check in on the States. I know I'm no expert, but it was cool.
No, but they were glad to hear you. They recognize your American accent. And on St. Patrick's Day, it's a special for them, and it's a special for you. And, of course, it's a special for us. And we're delighted to have you here.
Well, let me get a picture. It's almost last call. Let's hit another bar. That was drunk talk, Brad. Happy St. Pat's. Whoa. Oh, God. See that? Let's go.
anybody can take a cab, but if you really want to see a town, horse-drawn carriage, that's the way to do it. It's late.
3 a.m.
So you work late. Do you like working nights?
Yeah. Keeps me out of the pub.
Driving around, you must see some stuff.
An awful lot of drunks. Men just fighting amongst themselves.
Ooh. What's the name of your horse?
Kelly.
Kelly. You're doing good, Kelly. Let the meter run. Show me the sights.
This here is the Lord Mayor of Dublin's house.
Really?
This here is St. Anne's Church. It's now a bookstore.
What's that sound you're making?
Tells the horse to go on.
Wow. What's that horse on? Speed? How many people do this in Dublin?
There's 50 carriages in Dublin.
You don't get cold doing this, Chris?
No.
No? Gotta have some thick blood or some strong whiskey. What is that? That's a beautiful house.
That's the government building.
Check that out. Cool, man.
Okay.
Yeah. Onward.
This is Bram Stoker's house, the author of Dracula.
Let's see if the horse brays. All right. Sorry. You pick up the ladies, they must like. It's very romantic.
Two English guys wanted me to bring them to the nightclub. They'd only go with me if they could moan all the way up.
If they could what?
Moan. Flash.
Moon. Oh, flash. That's a little extra. They had to give you a little something extra for that.
Hi, yeah.
Gary, what part of town is this?
This is Fitzwilliam Square. This is actually a red light district.
Red light district, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. I knew my wallet was throbbing. Can I get a picture? Woo! Gary, thanks for showing me the sights. Right. And here's a little something for you, Kelly. There you go. Oh, I know you wanted a... There you go. Ooh. 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 Yes. I'm drunk. Well, what's the matter? What, your mom doesn't want to see you enjoying the nightlife of Dublin? Right?
No, she does.
No, probably not.
No,
actually.
She probably does.
She paid
probably
a lot of money does. For me to be here.
Yeah, well, you're studying, right?
Yeah, sort of.
You're studying the conversion of euros to pints.
Exactly.
Sure. Here's some new late night buddies. James, Quivine, yeah. Or Kevin.
Quivine.
You like Quivine better?
Yeah, I better.
Yeah, but you'll never find that on one of those little license plates. Quivine.
I never know.
Kevin.
Wouldn't fit, I don't think.
Right. I've got one last thing I have to do. Come on. Time to shear the sheep. So as I was saying, you know how it is. No one commits to a relationship. So you gotta move on. Kick that man to the curb. That's what I say. Did you see Barbershop? I did. What do you think of that Colin Farrell, huh? He's a hot dish. Notice how I haven't done a Jerry Lewis and Lamb Chop joke? Give me credit for that. And done. All right. You all right? There you go. All right. Go ahead. Next. Who's next? Shave and a haircut. Two bits. Ah. Irish wool. Great pictures, frosty pints, and a St. Pat's I won't soon forget. And as they say around here, may the devil know you're dead a half hour before you reach heaven. See you next week. Get some sleep!
comedycentral.com
Mattel's got a new attitude to go with his new stand-up special.
I'm the same bald fat guy who met you on MySpace. Deal with it.
It's the network television premiere of Captain Miserable. Premieres Sunday at 10 on Comedy Central.
It is awkward.
Hi, I'm Michael.
And I'm Michael.
No, that's how I say my name. No, Michael. No. Say it your way.